wrong way. I don't want to fight about it.
What are you? Scared?
Yes, I am. I'm a little scared. See, I don't know if I'm a boy or a girl yet.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, if you're a boy and I'm a girl, you can beat me up. You think I want to lose a tooth in my first day alive?
What's a tooth?
Search me. I'm just a baby. I don't know nothing yet.
Well, do you think that you're a girl?
I don't know. I've never been anything before. Let me see. Let me take a look around. Cute feet, small, dainty. Yup, I'm a girl. That's it, it's girl time.
What baby is you? What's a baby yourself?
A firefighter.
tell you?
What about you?
Our cocktail waitress. Did I prove anything to you yet?
Well, I guess you must be right.
I told you, I'm always right.
Oh, wait, here comes the nurse to change our diapers.
In about time, too. I've never been so uncomfortable in all my life.
Hey, look at that.
What?
I am a girl, and you're a boy.
It sure looks that way.
So, what do you think?
I can't understand. What?
You can't judge a book by its cover.
What do you mean?
How should I know? I'm only a baby.
Oh, so am I. Goo. Talk about it.
face for.
Me too.
$1. 2 hours.
Oh, yeah.
Bottom of the ninth. The pitcher throws the ball.
I swing. Pop. It's going. It's going. It's going.
Yay!
Yay! Let's go to the park.
Yeah.
And Sam keeps and make this whole city with this really neat pound shovel my dad used to play with when he was a kid.
Cool.
My dad would sit behind his house and dig up this big, fat, juicy worm. And then put him in his pail and bring him to his room where he kept him in a jar with his underwear.
Yeah.
A lot of
signs of life on this planet?
Shh, not yet. But they could be anywhere.
Oh.
Get out of your intergalactic language detectors. Be on your guard.
Told me that it was lots of fun to cook. and the put milk and sugar in it.
Smell!
men want to marry your daughter, and I do not know how to choose.
You will not choose, Father. I will choose. And I'm not sure that I will choose to marry anyone at all.
Huh. Of course you will. Everybody gets married. It's what people do.
As for me, I intend to go out and see the world. When I come home, perhaps I will marry, perhaps I will not.
The king did not like this at all. He was a very ordinary king. That is, he was powerful and used to having his own way.
I have decided how to choose the man you will marry. I will hold a great race. And the winner, the swiftest young man of all, will win the right to marry you.
Now, Atalanta, being a clever girl as well as a swift runner, saw that she might win the argument and the race, too.
Very well. But you must let me race along with the others. If I am not the winner, I will accept the wishes of the young man who is. If I am the winner, I will choose for myself what I will do.
The king agreed. He was pleased. He would have his way, marry off his daughter, and enjoy a fine day of racing as well. So he sent his messengers to travel throughout the kingdom, announcing the race with its wonderful prize, the chance to marry the bright Atalanta. As the day of the race drew near, flags were raised in the streets of the town. Each day at dawn, Atalanta would go to the field in secret and run across it. First slow, then fast, and faster, until she could run the course more quickly than anyone had ever run it before. Whew. As the day of the race drew nearer, many young men gathered in town. Each one was sure that he could win the prize. Except for one. That was young John, who lived in the town.
Surely it is not right for Atalanta's father to give her to the winner of the race. Atalanta herself must choose who she wants to marry or whether she wishes to marry at all. Still, if I could only win the race, then I would be free to speak with her and ask her for her friendship.
Each evening after his studies of the stars and the seas, young John would go to the field in secret and run across it until he could run the course more quickly than anyone had ever run it before. The day of the race arrived. All the young men gathered at the edge of the field, along with Atalanta. The king rose and addressed them all.
Good day. Good luck. Goodbye. I must say farewell, for tomorrow you will be married.
I'm not so sure of that, Father.
They were friends. The next day, young John sailed
because people have to tell you.
Like, y'all ready for this?
Woo!
Someone else can tell you how to multiply by three. And someone else can tell you how to go skin and candy. And someone else can tell you how to fight a two-wheel bike. But no one else can tell you.
What to bite?
Yeah, baby.
Huh. Everybody get up, get on the train now. We got the train track laid down, free to be you and me. Here's your chance, do your dance on the funky train. All right,
an engineer
should tell you how to run a railroad train.
A bus can tell you where to find the capital of Spain.
Where?
A bus can tell you all the names of every star above.
Yeah.
And no one else can tell you who to love.
True.
I'm Corey.
I'm Nina.
Mike.
Paul.
Liz.
How'd you guys like the show?
Great.
Does the princess and young John get tired from running?
Sometimes.
That's a very good question, though.
Anybody else have questions?
Right there.
Thank you. All right, we have time for one more question, okay? Right over here. No, you don't have to, but if you ever have the chance to, you definitely should. It's a lot of fun to be in a play.
I would suggest it.
Okay, if you guys